Hello, a little bit bright, isn't it? Let's see if we can find something to dull down the edges a little bit, shall we? Will this work? A little bit. Yeah. Oh, and that is something completely different. So we'll put him there anyway. Right, so here we go. I'm going to be doing, continuing on with my geometric paint gem. Paint gem mini. I've got a couple coming today. And I thought I'd go and use this tray. I'm a bit frustrated, really. Let's see, it's probably better without the light on, isn't it? Yep. I'm a bit frustrated with this one because I wished I hadn't got the purple. I wish I got a lighter colour. But it is gorgeous. So who knows? I might have to treat myself, but it's a good one for putting in your hand. But all these edges, I don't know. But there again, I think I'm going to treat myself to a kitting up kitten one soon instead. Right, so, oh dear, this makes it a little bit harder. L. All right, let's do the L's. Hope I've got the right pot. L. L. It would be good if there was a little bit of a legend or something, you know, on a sheet. I think that's what I'm going to have to do. So then I can, yeah, it's a bit hard without the light, but then this bit is a bit too bright. It's trying to see the shadows. I apologise for the shadows. My little lamp on an angle poise doesn't quite go that far. Oh, it's telling me it's done, so it should have cleaned it nicely, she says. Oh dear. Yeah, so I've got, what have I got coming today? Oh, I've got two parcels that I've got to send off, so the postman should be dropping them off, collecting them, I mean. And I've got my paint gem minis coming today, which I can't wait for. And this morning I was looking up on YouTube, you know, ways how to, you know, what are the best times for you know, putting up my videos, because I tend to try and put them up at 10 o'clock in the morning each day. But I thought I'd experiment and try and find it. So I found one video which was there saying do this, do that and the other. I thought, well, that's doable. Okay, it was 8 months ago, so it was a fairly recent video, but even then it seems like YouTube has updated or whatever and changed a lot of things around, so it's no longer applicable to a certain extent, I don't think. I did what one of them said, go to analytics, and then there it should have like a little thing of your times, and he showed it on his. But could I find that on mine? I couldn't find the times when people are clicking in mostly to watch my videos. So I couldn't. So I was kind of like at a loss, and I went into all kinds of you know, sections, changing everything around just so I could try and find it. Filters on, filters off, or oh, you name it. I still couldn't find it. I found this sort of one of those charts, but I didn't want a chart like that. I wanted, you know, so I had to work it out from that chart. But then that chart, I only did roughly what my, when I kind of like uploaded. And of course, people would be watching in at that point to a certain extent. But I wanted to see the time frame that people were working into, like this guy was there suggesting. So, well, so that was a bit problematic. I shall keep doing it at 10 o'clock, around 10 o'clock. And then what? Oh, another thing they suggested was switching it up because, you know, make people curious as to what your thingamajig is doing. And I noticed one of my cross stitch conversion kitting ups had a picture of Wang Yibo and Xiao Zhan, and their hair sort of front face sort of doodah things with their hair out the front, you know. And that one got quite a lot of looks, and I think a lot of that was because it's from the Untamed. And but then, you know, there's no point putting that picture up for, say, if I'm doing a geometric one. I mean, that'd be clickbait, and I ain't into that. So I don't know. So it's trying to find a way through that. Because at one point I was thinking, oh gosh, all these people's, you know, lovely creators' pages, you know, don't they look lovely and fresh and uniform and all that kind of stuff? But they look exactly the same, except they've just got different wordings on it. And I just thought, at one point I wanted to have something like that, do something. But then I thought, if everybody's doing that, yes, it is more professional looking, but if everybody's doing that, after a while, some people, because I know I would, and I do, get sort of fed up looking at that sort of style, because in part, I feel like I would never achieve that, and all it's doing is taunting me, which is crazy. It is crazy, but you know, that's how it goes, you know, low self-esteem and all that kind of jazz. But yeah, it's something that I would aspire to. So you know, it's a double-edged sword. I just don't know where I am in it all, you know, because on one hand I want to I want that, but on another hand, I want to have the free spirit and just do what I want to do when I want to do, which is kind of like my get out of jail free clause card thing, because where I do it, there's no real method to the madness, just madness to the method. And you know, that kind of goes alongside my chaotic and disorganized, you know, way of doing things. But well, I just don't know. I don't know what the answer is, so until I can find a way through, I will just do what I do, when I do, how I do. And yes, I'll change things up and I will change things down. And I will obviously never be consistent in how I do things, just when I do things. And that'll be, I will aim, if my laptop and everything else, not my laptop, my iPad and iPhone allow me to do it. But but yes. Oh, on that note, I found a good way through my storage issues. I watched a YouTube, obviously a YouTube. I mean, I've watched a gazillion of these YouTubes trying to find a way through the storage, and also to why people's batteries get hot and, you know, and don't seem to last that long. And a lot of it is because there's lots of apps running in the background and lots of things like that. So what they suggested I do and that is they gave us various ones to do just to clean up storage, empty your cash and everything else on Safari. I didn't get round to doing that because the one things that worked for me was I got shot of all, even though I had deactivated, they were still on my system, on my phone and my iPad. And so all the games and all the things that I had on there, except for the ones that I use regularly, because, well, it'd just be a pain if I have to reinstall those each time. But so I uninstalled all those, deleted them from the system, and then there was one which it said to do, and that is you go into Apple Apps and then click on any button on the bottom. I did the very first one because that's the one they did, and you apparently press it 10 times. You won't see anything happen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Close out of there, and then I restarted it, and can you believe it, from just doing those, I went down from, I couldn't believe it, 27 gigabytes. I only had 128. So I went down from that to, I think it was 50 something rather. Go figure. It worked. So my uploading actually worked nicely for a change. I mean, yes, it's still a little bit long because it's, you know, on wireless and all that kind of stuff, but it did it. So if your system is getting a bit too hot, getting a bit too battery life cracking up, you know, storage full or getting fuller, and you know, and you've done everything that you can to try and do it, definitely try that apps one. I don't know what it does, what it did, because it doesn't say, oh yes, it's done something or other. It just does it. And I mean, to suddenly go from, you know, 127 points, something or other it was in total, really, it went down to 50 odd. And that's a heck of a lot, isn't it? So deleting certain apps, because they also say that some of these apps also, you know, the ones which say have in-app purchases and all that kind of stuff, they also have lots of data, you know, for you to go off on these, you know, because they have all these ones, don't they, in-app purchases, where they send you off, you do a certain part of it, and then they send you off to look at this game. And of course, all those things have data. And of course, they're all, you interact in any way on those, and that data then sticks to your gizmo. So just be careful. It's not a case of purchasing them, it's a case of the data filling up your, you know, your storage. And by, you know, deleting the apps that you don't use, especially game apps, you are, you know, you're well on your way. And of course, then if you delete, you do the 10 taps on your, I mean, that could just be their thing. But I did check after I deleted the apps, I did check how much data had gone, and it was, as they said, you know, probably only about a gigabyte of data per app. But you know, it was amazing, absolutely amazing. So I didn't even need to get round to you know, deleting my internet, i.e. my Safari cache files and website data, which was, I was thankful for, because to kind of remember all the passwords again would be a bloody nightmare. Because the old thing that the people used to think was that iPhone, you couldn't get viruses on them. It's completely untrue nowadays. No. Because at one point, as the guys said, is that the reason why Apple preferred not to have anybody else's was because they would get, you know, they would get all the funds themselves. But now, offering third-party apps, which are not as regulated or tested as stringently as Apple have been, or, you know, or got no, you know, it all comes back to Apple, basically. These other ones, they haven't got that such loyalty, but Apple get like 30-40% is what they said, I think, of the apps, you know, to allow the apps to run on their systems. So, you know, for that, and they're doing nothing, they're just reaping in the money. Of course they're going to change it, but, you know, that doesn't add on to the viruses, doesn't quite add to the malware, the trackers and all that kind of stuff is what I got from it, but who knows. But either way, yeah, try it on your machine, especially if it's an iPhone. If it's Android, I'm not quite sure. It might work if you go into your, say, your Google Play or whichever one you get your apps from and try, you know, 10 times on one. It might do something. I don't know. Alternatively, do what I did, and that was do a search on YouTube. And you will find quite a lot of things. Why? I was supposed to be using this one, and I've been using that one. What a muppet. What a total doofus. Old habits, see? Old habits. Oh, yeah, I can't work this one out. I can't do it. Oh, well. All right, let's try again. I think I need to put another glue dot in. Oh, dear. Yeah, purple. That's got a bit darker. It's hard to see. And then with the shadow, I apologise for the shadow. I'm going to have to do it, aren't I? Oh, no. I'm going to have to turn the light pad on and it's so big. And I don't know whether you can see it. I can see better. And it's not dimmable, this one, so I can't even dim it down. So you have to tell me which is better. The one with light pad or the one without. Oh, come on. Let's just pull him up a bit. Because that's what a lot of it is. Yeah. So I'll try a new way of filming. I'll try a new way of doing things. And see how well that works. I'm afraid I don't edit because I can't. It's just way too complicated. Well, I managed to do my chair and it wasn't that hard in the end. Thankfully. I mean, yes, it was a little bit awkward. You do need, I think, in some parts, two people. And I'm going to have to go in and re-tighten up the some screws because it seems to go from side to side. But it's got the cat seal of approval. The cat sleeps on it now, which I'm not too happy about because cat has claws, and cat has fur, and cat has detritus. And so in the grooves of new chair is cat detritus, and that's even with putting a cloth down over the top of it. God knows how it manages, but I did find the cloth half on the floor, so I think the cat is just wanting the fake leather against its fur, whatever it is. I don't know what it is. It's plasticized leather, isn't it, or whatever they call it. But well, yes. I'm going to try and do one of these once a week at least, because I'm going to have a load more kits. Well, I've got two more kits coming, and here we go. So I'm going to try something. I don't know how well it's working, going to work. I mean, Christmas, I've got the Christmas kit. That one I've already unboxed and shown you that one. That one I'm going to do at Christmas time. So every day on Christmas, I'm going to do as many as they've got. I think they've got 16 in there. So I will be doing, starting on day one, I will be doing one of those per day. But I don't know which one it's going to be. I'm going to do a little sort of, you know, random pick of those. So I will have cover sheets on. Oh, and I just knocked these over. I'll have cover sheets on and... so I can't see the pattern. We know it would be Christmas themed. And then what I shall do is so I will do those up to the 16th, and then it might be a bit late, but I will put them, I will turn them into cards. No, it won't be a bit late, because what it will be is it won't be all of them. It'll be one at a time. So I will. So say day one, I do that one. I'll turn it into a card. And on day two, fingers crossed, I will have that listed on my Folksy store. And it'll work on from then. So next day I'll do day twos and so on, day three and day twos card and so forth. That's how I, yeah, that's really going to work. That's how I'm going to plan it. But best laid plans of mice and men, aren't I? I haven't got very far. I'm already 23 minutes in. What is going on? Oh, look, I've missed a blimmin' U. U 958. Yep, I had a complete day off from diamond painting yesterday. I think I needed it. I was so tired. So very tired. I slept quite a lot of the day, actually. But I knew I had to do some filming today to get ahead of the game. I don't know how some of these will last for all of them. I always worry that I'm going to run out. All right, what are we on? N. Yeah. Oh, I've got some compression socks. Got them off of Amazon, two pairs, because I thought, well, when one's in the wash, I've got another pair. And oh my God, the support and the comfort is amazing. Only thing is now my ankles that used to get quite swollen, now after the compression socks are, it's above where the sock ends, that's where it gets swollen for a bit, but not too bad. But that's because I'm sat basically at the table most of the day. Yes, I do get up because I have to, because I'm a back and all that kind of stuff. But sometimes I'm sat here for a good 3 hours. And I worry sort of, you know, about it. But, oh my God, the support of these. They are absolutely amazing. Absolutely, totally amazing. Yeah. I think these ones were $12.79 for two pairs. Which, for what they do and what they are, I am absolutely, I think that's a good price. I did think this geometric pattern would be quite good to do, you know, to get. But actually, now I've got it, I think, yeah, it's a little repetitive. Okay, not just a little repetitive, quite repetitive, because one square is exactly the same in all of them, which obviously is geometric, but there's no way I'm going to have enough for all the other ones that I've still got left to do, because that's all the drills I've got of this one. I mean, I've got extras of white and black. Well, we will see. I think I've got this colour. I hope I've got this colour. I probably will have somewhere, because I've got a load of cross-stitch conversions which I can possibly borrow from. But well, yeah, I saw the grandkids briefly on Saturday, because my son brought them briefly, because they had a christening to go to on Sunday apparently. So yeah, otherwise I wouldn't have seen them, and that would have made it my fourth Sunday I wouldn't have seen them, which would have been a bit much. So at some point this week I think I'll go and visit them at school, you know, after school obviously, you know, when they're being picked up. So it's my son, because my son's new baby, they're waiting the birth of this new baby, and he's due on the 3rd of October. And my son was there saying, oh yes, she started getting Braxton Hicks and noticing it's low in the old, you know, tummy and stuff. And I'm saying, oh, getting ready. Well, yeah, so I've got to rearrange his PIP assessment. I mean, 840 is just ridiculous. Yeah. to get round to doing that. Ooh, such a pain in the backside, it really is. I think I might swap it all over to this partner and him. Because I can do without the stress. And it is very stressful. Not just the phone calls of it all and all that kind of stuff, but it's the aftermath of the meltdowns. Autism, ASD, and ADD at any stages are exhausting. How are we doing on this one? 30 minutes. Usually they take me about 45. But I've been on a bit of a go so, and I am single placing. So I don't know whether I'll get to finish this one. Let's try. So the reason why I've been single placing is because I think I should have preloaded. Yeah, because it's not picking up very well. Oh dear. I've got to have to redo my whiteboard. I've got a whiteboard specifically for things to do, mainly on YouTube, and it's ended up being things to do around the house as well. But I'm not doing any of them. Well, I did a job that I meant to do. And that was clean the windowsill. Well, I haven't fully cleaned it. I've cleaned the bit that the cat goes on. So I'm going to need to move the rest of the stuff. And it isn't a very good job. I'm going to need to get soap and water to it as opposed to a wet wipe. And then while I'm there doing soap and water, I might as well open the windows, go outside. See, this is when it sort of then becomes a bit of a pig job, so it never happens. Because then I'd have to go outside, move the bins out of the way so I can get to the windows, and then lather them all up with hot soapy water. And then wipe them all down. And of course, all these extra jobs being added into it. Oh my God, just sort of puts me off, which is because then all I end up doing is just putting off the job and it never happens, or it does but half-heartedly. Let's have a slip of tea. Is it ready for it? Oh yes, that's ready. I'm itching for these ones of paint gems, some new ones to come. Come on, Posty. Posty, Posty, don't be slow. Be like Elvis, go Mango. See, that one doesn't even want to take up any. And now it's lost one. Back to single placing. I'm a single lady, I'm a single placer. I'm a single placing, I'm a single placer. I'm a single placer, I'm a single placing. Yeah, I think I feel a little bit diamond painted, burnt out a little bit from, you know, doing wonky circles 1 week, the Little Empowered Mermaid the next week, and now starting on City Digs with its lot of black. But yeah, so I needed to have a day off. And now I'm doing some little bits. Oh, yeah, it's raining. It's been raining. Good. I don't know. Have to load up that dishwasher again now it's had its clean. Right, where are we now? Down here, huh? Oh dear, this is crazy. I think I should finish these teas and then I will stop, because that's 36 minutes and that is long enough, isn't it? Oh no, I won't have finished it, but I will finish, I will keep going, but off cam. So I've done 2 videos today so far, then this will be the second, and I've got another few to do. I want to do a bit of so actually while the deck's clear on here, I should probably do a bit of my cross stitch conversion, because I want to do at least that once a week. So I've got a cross stitch conversion, so each week I would really quite like to have a kitting up and a kitting down if I can, a whip or 2, cross stitch conversion, something like that. I think I'm going to do, because before there'd never be any particular day, but I think I'm going to have a whip on a Sunday, something where you can just put it on hopefully and do other things. Will ask, if you haven't subscribed already, then please, please do so. And liking gets me noticeable by more other people. One thing I noticed when I was looking at the analytics book, it was quite interesting. I spotted the main countries that people were watching from. And USA got top whatever it was mode, followed by the UK. Then I had India, so thank you to all those watching in India. And then it was followed by Japan. And then I had Taiwan. And then all the other countries, mainly quite a lot of Asian countries. But there again, I think that's because I do have a lot, and I do go on a lot about the Untamed, Shaozan and Wang Yibo. Of course they're more famous over there. But yeah, I really think that they ought to do a tour of, like, you know, all the places in the filming of the Untamed, because I would definitely, I don't fly, I haven't flown, but I think I might risk it. I might go for it and do that. Because let's face it, once I'm on the darn plane, I can't choose to get off. So it'll be whatever it'll be. But at the end of it, I could have a very good memory. Well, I would have a very good memory, hopefully, if I make it back. So I really think they should do something like that, you know. Tour of all the places in the filming of it. And then maybe a few places, you know, visits to certain hotels that they might be at now. Like a right groupie. Me and my mobility scooter. Come here, Waggy-bo. Ooh, what a good boy you are. You give that Shao-Zan a run for his money. Oh, dearie, dearie, dear. That'd be quite a laugh, wouldn't it? Quite a giggle. Oh, sorry. Brain's gone off on one now. Oh, God. I love those two to bits. They are. They're my boys. Now, I don't want to do naughty things to them. I'd like to have, you know, be like mum, you know, and get mum cuddles and mum care and, you know, give mum cuddles and don't want to see them hurt. Want to support them. Mind you, Ebu is a bit way too young. Never would happen at any rate, would it? Good, come on. I'm in the real world. If I was, what, 18, I wouldn't be in the real world just then. And I think, yes, I could be with him. And yeah, right. No, you wouldn't. Because, hey, you're in the UK. He's in China. You wouldn't have flown anywhere. And you had no money. Oh, dear. Sorry. My mind's going off on one. I'm internally combusting. Oh, God. Okay. I will stop now. I will see you in the next one. Bye.